Hi, I'm Andy, physical therapist from Biomechanics. I have a patient here who is 3 weeks post meniscectomy, medial meniscectomy in her knee, removal of a torn cartilage. And it's common for people to get referred to therapy, and they start with strengthening and riding a stationary bike, all of which is very important. But at Biomechanics, we like to include a lot of manual, hands-on therapy also to help mobilize the problem. So this patient has some scar tissue right at the portals below her kneecap here, where the doctor did his good work. And for the most part, what I'm doing is I'm just taking my fingers and I'm stretching that scar tissue with my fingers a bit, just to try to get some mobility into that patellar tendon. And there's a fat pad under there that has to allow that to glide. So you can see I'm just kind of pushing right on that scar tissue, and that starts to mobilize that. In addition to that, I try to get the kneecap moving. The kneecap can be moved simply by getting a hold of it. We stretch it down and we stretch it upward and get that to glide a bit. So that's a second thing that we work on. And a lot of times we'll use this goofy thing. It's actually just a sink plunger, strangely enough, but it works very well. We just get a little suction right on there, and I put that right over her knee, and I give just a little bit of traction pressure on there, and I can move that kneecap around with this plunger. So household device that we use only in the clinic. We've not used it on a sink or a toilet, just on her knee, and that starts to mobilize that kneecap, okay? Then another thing that we can try to accomplish is to get her tibia and fibula to glide properly. And so what I'm going to do is I've got her stabilized here, and I'm just feeling the femur here on the tibia. The tibia is against this, and so the femur, I'm just gliding it backwards toward the table, and I can feel that it's a little tight when I try to glide it that way. It certainly shouldn't move very far, but it should be elastic. And so I'm just taking up the pressure with my hand here, pushing down on it to move that bone backwards, and that's one of the gliding mechanisms that we want to restore to that knee to allow that to move. By the same token, I can move this up, and I put that little round cylinder under there, and I stabilize the femur now with this hand, and now I'm moving her tibia this way. So it's a hinged joint that has to be able to glide this way properly. And if your knee feels kind of caught and stuck and tight after a surgery, or if you have a problem in your knee from degenerative arthritis or something, this is the way that we manually start to free that up. Makes a big difference compared to you just doing your exercises and riding a bike. Now if you would just flip onto your stomach, and what I can do is this area gets really tight. If you've had surgery ever, you know what I'm talking about. It gets stiff and sore and swollen back here. And we got to get in here with our hands and just first of all just milk that swelling out of there a little bit. And then secondly, get in there very locally, and we can feel, we know our anatomy really well, we know where all these muscles are, and we make sure that they're gliding and moving the way they're supposed to. Everything just gets kind of glued together sometimes. And soft tissue mobilization, the way we do it, gets in there and loosens some of those up. Now, I'm holding pressure with my left finger right on it. And if you would just pull your heel towards your butt, there you go, and relax. And again, pull, and relax, good. Now I'm on the lateral part of her gastroc here, pull again, and relax. Okay, and so that's something that starts to free that up. Typically, this patient was missing about 10 degrees of extension last visit. Today she walked in here at the beginning before I treated her and could get it to 5. And she said she felt so much better the rest of that day. So it's working well. Thank you very much. Come on in if you need this.